गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन क्लास ए पार्ट सेकंड, इंग्लिश लिटरेचर पेपर फर्स्ट। इन पेपर फर्स्ट एज यू नो वेरी वेल दैट वी आर रीडिंग पोएट्री सेक्शन एंड इन आवर पोएट्री सेक्शन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड वेरियस पॉइंट्स। नाउ टुडे वी हैव टू स्टार्ट our next point with its detailed study. Although in one video we have completed its basic introduction and the brief ideas, that is the point tears idle tears by Alfred Lord Tennyson. Tears idle tears by Alfred Lord Tennyson. It is the second video related to this point. In our previous first video related to concern point, we have discussed about the complete theme, about the thought of development and the structure. Now today we have to start its text line by line and try to consider the ideas, the sentiments given by text. We know that tears, idle tears is a poem very emotional. You may say it an elegic poem because the touch that was hidden in this poem is the deepness of suffering. It is the deepness of sorrow. Then there is some type of the personal reason that a person you can consider in poet. Weeps and weeps. The reason that was given by him is also domestic reason. That was also the relationship of love, and he just shows his troubles, his pains, his suffers, that how a lady is seen. That is a matter of consideration. That is a matter of to be noticed here, that poet meant a lot, and the reason that was given, that is later thing. We have just started its theme. Before that, the title must be clear in mind. As the rule of any poem or the system of a student of literature, very first we just conclude the introduction of poem as well as the introduction of poet. Now, when first we just discussed about the word's meaning of tears, you know that the word tear may have their two different meanings. Basically, I am talking about the word's lexicalized meaning of the word tear. Generally, we know that it has two proper meaning. First, if we just make separation of paper or anything other, separation of paper. Sometimes in special designs of paper, somewhere it is written that please tear from here, kripya yahan se phadiye, please ko phadiye. That is the first meaning of tear. Second meaning it is used for in this poem, that is tear, aansu, the drop of water from the eyes, the drop of water from the eyes, that is tear. S tears, idle tears, idle, various types of conception that was given. Jitti, alsi. Oh. Can we add the word tears and then connect it with idle? Can tears may be idle? Kya aansu alsi ho sakte hain? Ya you samjhe ki jaane ka naam hi nahi lete hain? Ya you samjhe non-stop tear? या यू समझे स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ टीयर, या यू समझे पोइट फील्स ए लॉन्ग ट्रबल, ए लॉन्ग सफरिंग फ्रॉम ए लॉन्ग टाइम, यानी देयर हैपेंड समथिंग इन लाइफ ऑफ एनीबडी, इफ देयर हैपेंड समथिंग दैट अटैक द हार्ट डीपली, दैट अटैक्स अपॉन इमोशंस, दैट अटैक्स अपॉन आवर फीलिंग्स, they happened in May. They happened the depressed or inside part. Our soul and psyche depressed a lot. I mean that this is a special type of mental position. It is a special type of mental position when this type of the position created. It is not a normal position. Tears that becomes permanent, tears that becomes stable, or tears, non-stop weeping. Matlab, not a normal suffering here. Not a normal trouble and problem here. There is something that was the great. There is something that was the depressed. Point fact, a very great depression, a very visible and serious depression that the company, now here you can understand the beloved of poet, the beloved of that gentleman, the beloved of that poet to whom poet had a lot of love, a lot of purity, a lot of intensive affection. Everything lost for that lady. All his love devoted for that lady. His life devoted for that lady. Totally dedicated love. Very full affection. Even the lady rejected him. All the gentlemen like his. What there may be upon that person, we never think. What may be happened with that person, we never think. Because this is not only an attack on that particular person. It is also an attack on the soft feeling. It is also an attack upon the pure heart. It is also an attack upon a good thinking, an honest sentiment, and 100% right emotions. So if it happened that if this type of the suffering and depression happened, surely the stress comes on the life, stress comes on the mind, inside it affects our psychology, it affects our mind, it affects our mentality, it affects our feelings, emotions, heart, sentiments, every inside flow that was affected by all these type of the attacks. So this is the position. Poet here speaking about the position of that person who was rejected by a lady to whom he loved the great. He was rejected by a lady to whom he dedicated and devoted his whole affection, his whole love, his whole life. What happened with that type of lady? That was result, tears, idle tears. The poem that was written by Tennyson. The name of Tennyson, you know very well, that is Alfred Lord Tennyson. That is Alfred Lord Tennyson. The great representative poet of Victorian era with Robert Browning. When the name Tennyson starts, when there is the name related to the title of Victorian period, all these like Tennyson and Browning may always be considered on the top. Tennyson's various points we have read in memoriam. The most impressive, the most unique elegic poem written by Tennyson. Generally, he just touches the matters related to sorrow, related to suffering, and likeness. So here, that is the thing that is important to know about the ideas and the facts related to Alfred Lord Tennyson. You just know that this poem, that is Tears, Idle Tears, published in Princes, a collection of poems by Tennyson. Princes, a collection of poems by Tennyson. The thing that is important in this poem, in very starting he just speaks about his suffering. Not his telling about the results. He is weeping and weeping and weeping. He says that I am weeping. My tears are coming. It is not a stop and non-stop weeping. But he is not telling the results. In starting, he said that I don't know why the tears there are in my eyes. He says that I don't know why the tears there are in my eyes. And in the last part of the poem, everything was cleared by the poet that he is weeping now because he was rejected with a very beautiful letter. Because he was rejected by his beloved, because he was rejected by faithless behavior, because his soft heart, his pure and dedicated love rejected by a selfish love. All these are in this poem. Now I request you, you just read it line by line. We have the poem Tears, Idle Tears. You must have it in your hand. As in request, every time, whenever you read poem, you must have text. So, you know, in the introduction of poem, I am repeating the line, try to understand. And Tennyson was born in 1809. It is not, you can say that you can be need to read. Yes, the timing of every poet is must to know everywhere. The timing of every poet must to know everywhere. For the time being, I will just provide you the PDF notes of all these questions. Then we have sufficient introduction in written. So this is not a matter to be thinking more. I will provide you the notes of every questions either in classroom from January, otherwise in this group where you are watching the video, I will provide you the PDF notes. He was one of the 12 children of his parents. Most of his brothers were inclined towards poetry. With his brother Charles, he wrote many works and published them in a small volume, Poems by Two Brothers. Very important. Poems by Two Brothers, 1827. Poems by Two This is the collection written by Tennyson with his brother. This is the collection written by Tennyson with his brother. Means from family background, he was just found a company related to literary achievement and literary company. So this was the Poems by Two Brothers in 1827. Important, and try to note down it. Next year he entered Trinity College, Cambridge. At college he won Chancellor's Medal for a poem, Timbuktu. The University Achievement of Tennyson. Important matter that started in 1830. He published his poem called Poems Chiefly Lyrical in 1833. His brilliant friend Arthur Hallam died. Yes, Arthur Hallam was a very close and intimate friend of Tennyson. He composed various elegies for him. Same as I am giving you the example of Break, Break, Break. That was a poem written by Tennyson and based upon the death of his close friend. Arthur Hallam must be remembered. The name is very important. He was poet's close friend, and poet has written various types of the poem. Name must be noted down by you. Arthur Hallam, the name of Tennyson's friend, the name of Tennyson's friend for whom he composed various poems. Break, 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 three times break. It's a very beautiful or emotional break, break, break.
the poem you may call it an elegy, written by Tennyson in the memory of his close friend. He wrote an elegy in memoriam, in his memory.
उसकी याद में उसने जो elegy लिखी थी, that's name was in memoriam.
In memoriam, 1850
में लिखी थी. 1850. So that is a common introduction related to Alfred Lord Tennyson. Now there is the need to read its text. Now there is the need to read its text. You are requested to observe in your book. Text is important anywhere, either point of view of your questions and your explanation. Now starts with me. Tears, either tears, Kumalakya, that means the title coming at the first line. Poet is providing the scene. Poet is giving you the atmosphere of the location, on which location or locality the poem has written. The poem has written on the location or on the background of sadness. So this is tears, idle tears, represents about the background of poem. Or background of poem, you can say that it is very emotional and sorrowful background. A very emotional and sorrowful background. I know not what they mean. They is using for tears. I know not. Main nahi janta what they mean. Uska matlab kya hai? Now there is the thing that is important. Poet says that the background of my poem is totally weeping background. Totally suffering background. Even I am weeping and weeping and weeping, but I don't know why I am weeping. I am weeping from a long time, and my tears are not speed to stop. My tears are not ready to stop. You may call it a non-stop suffering or non-stop weeping, but even then, although I am weeping from a long time, but I don't know why I am weeping. So this is the line that is something conclusive. Everyone who weeps must know the reason. Weeping depends upon sentiments and emotions. It is not a dramatic play of weeping, but an original conception of weeping. That's later poet describe about the reason. Ab dekhi karan, tears from the depth of some divine despair. Tears, aansu, from the depth, gehrai se. Aansu jo gehrai se nikal rahi hai, some divine despair. Despair is nirasha, divine is pavitra. To kisi pavitra nirasha ki wajah se, yani poet has lost their hope. Poet has lost their hope. This is a very pure and divine hope. Poet has lost the hope, and this is very pure and divine and honest hope. Or when we have lost this type of divine thing, this type of hope, surely the tears from eyes. तो उस पवित्र निराशा जो एकदम मतलब गहरी निराशा चोट बड़ी गहरी थी राइज इन द हार्ट और ये दुख कहां पे इकट्ठा हो रहा है ये हार्ट में इकट्ठा हो रहा है दिल में इकट्ठा हो रहा है एंड गैदर टू द आईज और ये सारा का सारा दुख आईज में जाकर के इकट्ठा गैदर मींस इकट्ठा हो रहा है मींस पोएट इज स्पीकिंग अबाउट द सोरो एंड सेज दैट दिस इज माय सोरो दैट गैदर्ड इन माय हार्ट दिस इज माय सोरो दिस इज माय सफरिंग that collect in my heart or there is the space that is very limited space or when there is overflow that tears is coming out from the eyes as the system when our heart never bear when our heart cannot bear the suffering or the sorrow inside then it comes out how it comes out through the drop of waters it comes out through the tears. So same the position is there is a very deep sorrow, there is a very deepness in suffering, and that all these suffering are gathered inside, and that's why poet is weeping
हेयर।
नेक्स्ट इसने लिखा है, इन लुकिंग ऑन एन हैप्पी ऑटम फील्ड्स एंड थिंकिंग ऑफ द डेज दैट आर नो मोर, द डेज दैट आर नो मोर, द डेज दैट आर नो मोर, द लाइन रिपीटेड वेरियस टाइम्स, द लाइन रिपीटेड वेरियस टाइम्स, द डेज दैट आर नो मोर, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस ऑफ दिस टाइम। Poet is now communicating. He is now speaking about the days when he was in the company of his beloved, the days when he was very happy, the days when he closed, he attached, he was in company of his beloved. वो सारे के सारे दिन अब नहीं रहेंगे. And it was the reason why he is weeping. It was the reason of tears, idle tears. That poet has lost the days of happiness. The poet has lost the days of company of love. The poet has lost the days of his beautiful life. Because the reason she rejected him. Reason now he is alone. Reason his pure love defeated by a lady. Reason his emotions and sentiments attacked by self-full love. This was the reason, and the days that are no more. Now he is speaking about the scene where he was with his company, where he was with his beloved. वो सारे की सारी आपको autumn season के दृश्य दिखा रहा है, लाइन देखिए। In looking on the happy autumn, पतझड़ की ऋतु के वो खुशी के दिन, field and thinking, जब मैं उस field की बात करता हूँ, उस खेत कल्याण बात की बात करता हूं जहां पे आई वॉज विद हर इन दैट फील्ड ड्यूरिंग ऑटम सीजन, आई वॉज विद हर इन दैट फील्ड बट दैट डेज आर नो मोर। फ्रेश एज द फर्स्ट बीम, फर्स्ट मीन्स पहली बीम मीन्स किरण सूर्य की, ग्लिटरिंग ऑन ए शेल, जैसे ही शेल के ऊपर बोट नाव के ऊपर सुबह का समय है, सूर्य की चमकती हुई किरणें, दैट ब्रिंग्स आवर फ्रेंड्स अप फ्रॉम द अंडरवर्ल्ड, सैड एट द लास्ट विच रेडन्स ओवर वन दैट सिंक्स विद हिज ऑल विद ऑल वी लव बिलो द वर्स। इन थ्री एंड फोर लाइंस देयर वाज ही इज स्पीकिंग अबाउट द मोमेंट, देयर ही इज स्पीकिंग अबाउट द कंपनी, दैट वेयर आई वाज विद हर कंपनी, एवरीथिंग वाज स्टार्ट्स विद हर, my day was starts with her, everything, every activity, every task, every happening never started without her, and at the first time, at the first beam of the sun, I have just started my days with her, and but now what is the meaning or what is the use of that days, because the days that are no more, I have lost her, I have lost my pure love, I have lost my everything. So sad, so fresh. वो इतनी ताजगी वाली चीज, starting वाली चीज, morning की freshness, so sad. अब तो मेरे एकदम दुखद हो गई है. यानी the beam, first beam of the sun was very beautiful there. It was very fresh there when she was with me. The beam of morning was very fresh there where when she was here. But now she is not here. Then what is the meaning of that first beam for me? What is the meaning of starting of day for me? What is the meaning of freshness of day for me? What is the meaning to get a new enjoyment of morning, early morning time for me? Because that freshness now becomes very sad. So sad, so fresh is a negative sense in a positive way. So sad, so fresh. Try to read. So sad, so fresh. A negative sense in positive way. Sakaratmak drishya mein nakaratmakta ke bhav. A positive atmosphere, positive location, positive atmosphere. Even then, everything happens negative for poet. Sab kuch positive hone ke baad bhi poet ki life mein sab cheeze nahi ke barabar hai.
बिकॉज उसने अपनी बिलव को खो दिया, बिकॉज उसकी बिलव उसको धोखा दे करके चली गई। इसके बाद कोविड के लिए जिंदगी की एवरी हैप्पीनेस, एवरी एंजॉयमेंट, एवरी गुड थिंकिंग, एवरी फ्रेश एटमोस्फियर, एवरी ब्यूटिफुल सीन, ऑल दे आर मीनिंगलेस फॉर हिम। इन सारी चीजों का उसके लिए कोई मायना नहीं है अगर उसकी बिलव उसको छोड़ के चली गई तो। नाउ ही सेज टीयर्स आइडर टीयर्स, हाउ आई कैन स्टॉप माई टीयर्स और हाउ आई टीयर्स कैन बी स्टॉप ऑटोमेटिकली बिकॉज आई हैव लॉस्ट एवरीथिंग। तो दिस इज सो सैड, सो फेस द डेज दैट आर नो मोर, द डेज दैट आर नो मोर। तो दिस वॉज द वेरी फर्स्ट हाफ ऑफ द पोएम एंड इन दिस फर्स्ट हाफ ऑफ पोएम वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट टीयर्स आइडल टीयर्स एंड देन वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द पोजिशन ऑफ पोएट, वी हैव ऑल्सो इंट्रोड्यूस अबाउट द लोकेलिटी एंड अबाउट द बैकग्राउंड। द पोएम रिटन ऑन ए वेरी सैडफुल एंड ए वेरी ट्रबलियस एटमोस्फेयर and the picture of a lover that was presented here and it was also a picture to be considered in our next video related to tears, idle tears. We will start the next part of it. Thank you.